Hello, this is David. I'm a principal engineer at Dell, and in this video I'm going to be covering how to properly rename an Active Directory domain controller. Renaming a DC is not something that has to be done very often, and the procedure is not difficult, but it can be a little tricky. It is very important that you make sure you have a good backup of at least one domain controller in your domain before trying to rename a DC. Just in case something goes wrong. This is especially important if your domain contains only a single domain controller, as a problem with that DC may result in the loss of the entire domain. And remember that a backup of a domain controller must include the system state. Some sources online state that you can rename a DC by going here and clicking change, just like you would for any other domain joined machine. But in my experience, that doesn't always work. It can cause authentication problems, and in fact, I have seen those problems be extensive enough to where the domain controller required a full OS reinstall in order to once again process authentication requests. So we're going to do it a different way using a series of netdom commands. So we'll launch an elevated PowerShell prompt or command prompt, either one is fine. As you may have noticed, this DC is named 2022 test. I want to change its name to DC2. It's one of two DCs in this domain, with DC1 being the other one. Before we start the rename, it's important to make sure that replication is working. So we check repadmin/showrepl, and it shows success for all five partitions. Let's check it in the other direction. And that shows success as well, so we know AD replication is working fine. So we can go ahead and proceed. The first command we want to run is netdom computer name, and then specify the current name of the DC, which is 2022test.ad.domain.com, then /add:, and the name that we want to change the DC to, so dc2.ad.domain.com. And this adds that name as an alternate name for the domain controller. And we can confirm that by running netdom computer name, the name of the DC, and /enumerate. That will list all names in use by the DC. We see 2022 test on top, then DC2 next. What we want to do is run a slightly different command to make DC2 the primary name. So basically we'll run the netdom computer name command with the /make primary switch. Everything else will be the same as in the first command. All we're changing is add to make primary. And the output of that command says successfully made dc2.ad.domain.com the primary name for the computer. The computer must be rebooted for this name change to take effect. Until then, authentication probably won't work. So now we need to reboot the DC, and we'll do that with a shutdown command. And we'll skip a bit here. We don't need to show the entire boot process. Okay, and now we're back. If we click on local server here in Server Manager, we will see that the computer name of this DC is now DC2. So that name change is successful, but we're not quite done because it's still using its old name as an alternate name. And we want to get rid of that. So there's one more netdom command we need to run. Netdom computer name, specify the new name of the DC, and then /remove, and specify the old name. And that removes the old name as an alternate name. We can run the enumerate command again to confirm this. And we see dc2.ad.domain.com is the only name in use. Now let's go to AD Sites and Services real quick. And you'll see that the new name shows up here. We'll force replication in both directions. And then use repadmin again to confirm that that worked. Complete success there. And check the other direction. Also complete success for all five partitions. So the DC rename has completed successfully. We have confirmed that replication still occurs. And that's it. This DC is now named dc2.ad.domain.com. Once again, my name is David. I'm a principal engineer at Dell, and thank you for watching.